Myself, Muhammad Yunus Sheikh, Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Engineering College, Bikaner. Now, in the series of lecture for the subject Theory of Machine, here we will discuss about the topic which is cams and follower. In the previous lectures, we have discussed about some theory aspect of the design of cam and follower. In this slide, we will discuss about some basic problem. In this problem, we have to design a follower which is moving with simple harmonic motion, and type of follower is the roller follower. Let us see what other things are given. Here, a cam with a minimum radius of 25 mm rotating clockwise at a uniform speed is to be designed to give a roller follower at the end of valve rod motion described below. We have to design a cam and cam profile and roller follower. Now here 120 degree rotation of cam follower lift through 50 mm, it means it is a stroke of follower which takes place for the 120 degree rotation of cam. After that, for the next 30 degree of rotation of cam, there is no upward or downward movement of the follower takes place. It means it is the dwell period. It is the angle corresponding to the dwell period, and the angle corresponding to the return period for the width for valve follower takes place in downward direction, and the corresponding angle is 60 degree. It means it is the angle of return. After that, for the remaining 150 degree angle rotation of cam, there is again a dwell period of follower which take place at the bottom position. Now the diameter of roller is 20 mm and diameter of camshaft is 25 mm. We have to draw the profile of cam in the two cases. In first, the line of stroke of valve passes through the axis of cam, and in the second, there is offset of 15 mm takes place between them. The displacement of valve being raised and lowered is takes place with simple harmonic motion. It means follower motion is simple harmonic motion, and we also determine the maximum acceleration when cam rotate with 100 rpm. Now we have to draw the displacement, velocity and acceleration diagram for one complete revolution of the cam. In the very first case, we have to draw the displacement versus theta plot. The process is same as we discussed earlier. We choose any arbitrary point A, and from here we draw a horizontal line AX of any convenient length. Suppose say it is 14 cm. Now from A, we draw a vertical line AY whose length should be equal to 50 mm, or it may be converted into scale, some suitable scale. Here 50 mm means 5 cm. We can easily draw a vertical line of 5 cm on the plane of paper. Now with this 50 mm as a diameter or C dash as a center, we draw a semicircle. We obtain this semicircle here and divide this semicircle into equal number of even parts. Suppose here we divide this semicircle in 6 parts, so each part make an angle 30 degree at the center of semicircle. Now after that, we obtain a different point A, B, C, D, E. From all these points, we draw a horizontal line in the similar way as we discussed earlier. Now from point A, we mark a point 6 at a suitable distance such that this length A6 can be easily divided into same number of parts as we divide this semicircle. So if we draw a length A6 as 6 cm, so we can easily divide into 6 parts, and length of each part is 1 cm. So in this way, we can mark the different points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. After that, there is a dwell period for 30 degree. So it doesn't matter what is the length of 6 to 0 dash takes place. It may be 1 or 2 cm. So here we mark a point 0 dash. from 0 dash, we mark another 0.6 dash to some suitable scale. Again, this 0 dash 6 dash length can be easily divided into 6 number of part. Again, we can take this length, suppose here it is 120 degree. So if we mark this length as 120 degree, so it should be it is the length of A6 is 120 degree and the length is 6 centimeter. So 60 degree rotation of cam indicate the length O dash 6 dash is 3 centimeter. So we should draw the length of this line O dash 6 dash equal to 6 centimeter. Now if we mark different points 1 dash 2 dash 3 dash 4 dash 5 dash at a distance of 5 mm, 5 mm, 5 mm, 5 mm, so the six parts length of six part is 3 centimeter. Now from the point 1 dash 2 dash 3 dash 4 dash 5 dash we draw a vertical line, and we also extend the horizontal line from A B C D E. Now first the intersection of 1 and A is B, from 2 from vertical and horizontal, B from horizontal, it intersect at C, and vertical from 3 and horizontal from C is intersection at D, vertical from 4 and horizontal from D intersect at E, vertical from 5 and horizontal from E intersect at F, and vertical from 6 horizontal from Y intersect at G. There is a dual period, horizontal line, this is point H. Now we move in the downward direction, so from E we intersect this up to here, so 1 dash and E intersect at point J. Similarly 2 dash and horizontal from D intersect at K. In the similar way we can obtain the point L, M and P. Now we draw these points with the help of a smooth curve, and we obtain a displacement diagram for the follower in case of simple harmonic motion of the follower. Now this is the acceleration velocity, this is the velocity diagram for the follower, and this is the acceleration diagram for the follower. This is the maximum velocity of follower for the outward stroke. It is the maximum velocity of the follower during the return stroke. It is the maximum acceleration for the outward stroke, and it is the maximum acceleration for the return stroke. Now in order to draw cam profile, first in very first case with center O and radius equal to the, that is given in the question, what is the radius, is that 25 mm. So with center O as a center and 25 mm as a radius, first we draw this base circle. After that we draw a prime circle. Here it is a base circle, the radius of the base circle is 25 mm, and the prime circle is a circle whose radius is equal to the distance between the center of roller and center of cam. It is O and A. A is the center of roller, radius of roller is 10 because it is diameter is 20 given in the question. So 10 plus 25, it is 35. So with center O as a center and 35 mm as a radius, we draw another circle which is known as prime circle. The prime circle is equal to, the radius of prime circle is the radius of base radius of cam plus radius of roller, it is 35 mm. Now from point O draw a vertical axis, and this vertical axis cut the prime circle at point A. Now we have to mark an angle 120 degree with the base OA. So from OA there is a 120 degree angle AOS. This is angle AOS which is equal to the 120 degree. Now we divide this angle 120 degree into 6 number of part, so each part indicate an angle of 20 degree. Now from S O line we draw an angle 30 degree. So S O T, So this is SOT line, SOT. This line should be equal to 30 degree, which corresponding to the dwell period. Now from TO line we draw another angle of 60 degree, TON, TOP. So angle TOP, it should be equal to 60 degree. Now this angle corresponding to the return stroke, we also divide this angle into 6 number of equal part. So each part indicate an angle of 10 degree. Now the remaining portion is again the dwell period. Now we mark the point 1, 2, because when we divide this angle into number of equal parts, then it cut the prime circle at the different points like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0-1-2-3-5-6-. So we mark all this point and extend we join the point 1 from O and extend here outward direction. From 2 we join it O and extend also another direction. From 3 we join this and extend. So from all these points we draw a line passes through O and extend in the other direction. So we obtain these different lines. Then with the help of this diagram we measure this 1B, 2C, 3D, 4E length. We mark different points in this vertical line. From suppose say from point 1 we mark a point B which must be same equal to as shown in the displacement theta plot. Similarly from point 2 we mark point C, from 3 mark point D, E, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, and P. It is on the prime circle. So we mark all these points in the same way. After that, because the follower in this case is the roller follower, so we have to draw the different circles with the roller radius as the radius. It means from point B we draw a circle whose radius is equal to the radius of roller. It means roller diameter is 20 mm, so its radius is 10 mm. So with center B and radius equal to 10 mm, we draw a circle. Similarly with center C we draw a circle from D, E, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, O, N, P. We draw a different circle, identical circles whose radius is equal to 10 mm. Now with the help of smooth curve we join the bottom of all the circle. This is the bottom of the all the circuit, means we can say that these are the tangent at the bottom, passes through the bottom. From point starting from this point we draw a smooth curve which touches the bottom of all these circles and join this, and this is the semi, says it is a circular portion. So in this way we obtain a cam profile. And if we join the smooth curve which passes through the center of the roller, it means passes through the A, B, C, D, E. So these curve, in this way we obtain the curve which is known as pitch curve. So it is a pitch curve and it is a cam profile. It is the actual profile of the cam. This is known as cam profile. So these are the different same process which we discussed here is given in these points. Now in case of offset follower, what we first, the process, initial process are same. Draw a base circle with radius O center and radius equal to 25 mm. We draw a base circle with center O and radius equal to 25. So here it is a base circle. Now for draw a prime circle with center O and radius equal to 35. So it is OA radius which is equal to 35. We draw a prime circle. Now draw offset circle with center O and radius equal to 15. So this circle, in the most inner circle, is known as offset circle whose radius is 15 mm. Now join the offset is given as 15 mm. We draw a vertical line which passes through or just touches this offset circle. This vertical line cut the prime circle at point A. Now we join the point O to A. Now from point A, we mark an angle of 120 degree. So angle AOS is equal to 120 degree. We divide this circle into 6 number of parts and mark the corresponding parts on the prime circle only. Suppose first part meet the prime circle at point 1, second part meet at 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now from S we draw an angle SOT which is equal to 30 degree and it is the corresponding dwell angle. From T we draw an angle TOP whose angle is 60 degree. Now we divide these angle into 6 number of parts, so each angle indicates 10 degree, and we mark this point here only 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash and 6 dash. Now in this way we obtain all these points from 0 to 6 and 0 dash to 6 dash. Now from point 1 we draw a tangent to outside circle. From point 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0 dash, 1 dash, from all these points we draw a tangent to this offset circle and extend in the other side also. Another process are same. From point 1 we mark point B such that 1B length is same as given in the displacement curve. Similarly from 2 we can obtain the point C, from 3 we can obtain the point D, from 4 we can obtain point E, from 5 we can obtain point F. In the similar way, we can obtain point G, H, J, K, L, M, and P. Now, if we join these points with the help of a smooth curve, then we obtain the pitch curve. This curve is known as the pitch curve. Now, with all these points from A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, and P, with all these points as a center and radius of roller as a radius, if we draw different small circles, and after that if we draw a smooth curve which touches the inner part of this circle, then we obtain the curve which is the known as cam profile in case of offset follower. So here we draw a profile of cam in both the cases. When the axis of shaft follower passes through the axis of cam, and when the axis of follower is offset to the axis of cam. Now these relations we have derived in the theory, that the maximum velocity during the outward stroke of the follower is given by pi omega s divided by 2 theta naught. Here the angle of outstroke must be written or mentioned here in only radian. The speed of rotation is given, so from the relation 2 pi n upon 60 we can find out the value of angular speed which is in radian per second, and during the return stroke theta naught replaced by theta r. So here v naught it is obtained as 0.39 meter per second, vr obtained as 0.785 meter per second, and in the similar way there is a relation used for obtaining the maximum acceleration for the outstroke, and here it is the maximum acceleration during the return stroke. So in this way we can obtain the maximum velocity and acceleration during the outward stroke and the return stroke. Thank you.